much for giving me the opportunity to make a short speech. Women's Day is celebrated worldwide tomorrow. The 2017 theme is Default for Change. What does this mean? The World Economic Forum predicts that the gender gap won't close entirely until 2186. Yes, you heard well, until 2186, only in 169 years. It is more than obvious that we have to speed up this process. We have to act now. So around the world, this year's International Women's Day provides an important opportunity for actions that can truly drive greater change for women. Every person can play a part in helping drive better outcomes for women. Through meaningful celebration and targeted bold action, we can all be responsible and responsible leaders in creating a more gender-inclusive world. Therefore, I congratulate the organizers for this event. The European Parliament, as a political institution, is fully committed to promoting the values of gender equality and diversity in all the forms listed in the treaties and the Charter of Fundamental Rights. Women's participation and their contribution to the political process are both significant and necessary, not to say a fundamental right in itself. The European Parliament seems to be on the right track. In the first legislature, after the first direct election of the European Parliament back in 1979, there were only 16.6% female members. Following the 2014 elections, the percentage of women in the European Parliament increased once more. Now, 281 female members represent 37.4% of the members of our institutions. Today, the European Parliament has a level of representation of women above the world average for national parliaments. In addition, the number of female vice presidents have risen from 3 in the previous parliamentary term to the present 5 out of total 14. Today, 12 women chaired a committee or a subcommittee. This shows that there is an improvement in the integration of women in the decision-making process. I'm very pleased about the fact that the leading positions have been opened up more widely to our women colleagues, as it is a proof of the cultural shift taking place within the political groups and their member parties. In the European Parliament, there are currently 8 political groups, and 3 of them are chaired by women, including mine, which actually is also perfectly gender balanced by having 50% of female and male members. 3 other groups have about 40% of female members. Please feel free to pick up one of the paper copies of the 2017 brochure, Women in the European Parliament, in order to have the full set of information. The European Parliament should act as a role model, not only in its legislative role, but also as an employer, thus promoting the values of equality, non-discrimination, diversity in Parliament's administration is strongly emphasized. A number of priorities have accordingly been identified for gender equality, for instance, promoting full equality in every aspect of working life, or developing an open, inclusive working environment for women and men alike. The high-level group on gender equality and diversity that I have the pleasure to chair promotes and implements gender mainstreaming in Parliament's activities, structures, and bodies. The high-level group is an horizontal body that cooperates closely with other Parliament bodies, particularly with the Committee of Women's Rights and Gender Equality and its rapporteur on gender mainstreaming, Mrs. Lienaar, present here today. Furthermore, the Bureau of the European Parliament unanimously adopted at its meeting of 16 of January 2017 the report on gender equality in the European Parliament Secretariat, State of Play and the Way Forward 2017-2019, which I drafted and presented to the EP Bureau on behalf of the high-level group. It seems that among the main obstacles ahead of a fully gender-balanced working environment is the glass ceiling that is limiting women access to management positions. The report also states that the figures on gender balance are still not at a satisfactory level and suggest not only maintaining existing tools and measures, but also pushes for the introduction of new methods to be tested and implemented. The proposed measures aim at identifying specific needs for training, a better working life balance, as well as more gender sensitive procedures for selections and appointment of staff. The report also concludes that more awareness raising events should be organized and efforts should also be made to give greater visibility to senior women managers. I am happy and confident that the follow-up of this report will lead to substantial changes in the near future and make our institution a fully gender-balanced workplace. Having organized this event on the occasion of the International Women's Day also reveals our commitment to put an end to gender-based discrimination once and for all and make equality between men, women, and not binary people part of individual consciousness and routine practice. The European Parliament staff members can count on me as the Vice President of Parliament responsible for gender equality and diversity to continue promoting initiatives and expecting positive outcomes. I now have the pleasure to give the floor to Mrs. Lienaar, who will speak on her personal experience as a female politician and her experience with social media during political campaigns. Thank you for your attention very much.